So the Maga Bomber, or as I like to call him, the Bootleg Bomber, has been caught. He was caught yesterday. So they say he is a 56-year-old Native American man named Caesar. So this is a little awkward. I never knew that there was actual Native American or Indigenous Americans that are Trump supporters. It's a little disheartening to find out that my brethren might be mixed up in the MAGA crowd. I guess you have difference of opinions everywhere. So obviously the right-wing propaganda machine has been spinning its wheels since these first bombs or fake bombs arrived in the mail, saying that they were pushed out by liberals and backed by Soros and all this other crap. And then after the guy was caught, there was a whole bunch of fake Facebook like profiles going around that he was a member of Antifa and he was a huge diehard liberal and all this stuff. But then when you start peeling back the layers of the onion, finding out who this person really is, you find out that he's a Trump supporter, lifelong Republican. You know, he's bankrupt. He owes a bunch of money to the electric company and this company and that company. Doesn't pay his bills. Lives with his mom. I mean, geez, is this the definition of what Trump supporters really are? I'm starting to think so, because a lot of the ones I run into, you know, some are good people and some kind of fit this bill. And it's just really weird because I don't know. Part of this makes me want to laugh, but it's a very serious situation. These people are obviously deranged. You know, they talk about Trump derangement syndrome. I had a guy on Facebook told me I have Trump derangement syndrome. And I think the Trump supporters are the ones with the Trump derangement syndrome because they can't really understand how bad this guy really is. And they don't see themselves as like this guy. Caesar, whatever the hell his name is. And it's like, come on, guys. Look at your circle. See who's around you and understand that this is your representation, you know? I mean, it's okay to have differences of opinions and all this other stuff, but the loons are definitely clinging to the right. And if I was a Republican, I would be pretty embarrassed that these people are representing me. Just like if I was a Democrat, I'd be embarrassed that certain Democrats are representing me. But I think the GOP takes the cake, man. Anyway, they got the bomber. And let's hope there's no copycats or anything else like that. It's a good thing that he's a failure, and it's a good thing that he, you know, obviously doesn't understand how to do this kind of stuff. I don't understand why Trump and his administration won't call it terrorism. It's definitely domestic terrorism. You know, more bullshit from the people on the right. They're saying that this was a setup. The guy's van is littered with, like, anti-liberal bumper stickers and pictures of people like Obama with targets on their head and stuff. And all you're hearing is these trumpets saying, oh, no, it's fake. Those are fake pictures. You know, this is a setup. He's a straw man. It's like they can never have responsibility for anything. There's a school shooting. It's a false flag. You know, there's domestic terrorists and, you know, the Ku Klux Klan, all those other things. Nope, that's fake. That doesn't really happen. Now you got the MAGA bomber or the bootleg bomber. And oh no, that's not real. It's like these people don't live in reality and then they want to call everything fake news. It's like, get into the real world, man. This is really the world we live in. And, you know, you people want civil war and all this other shit, all these like overweight, you know, welfare, sucking up, living with their parents type low lives, claiming they want civil war. What are you going to do? Come after me with your sword? Like, get out of here, dude. You know, and it's just scary, man. Somebody like me, I don't want civil war. I want peace. You know, I'm not afraid of the war. And I guarantee you, I guarantee you I'll be okay if there is a civil war. Me and my family will be just fine. But I feel like that's not necessary, you know. And it's shit like this that's just going to push us to that level. Can't we just all stop the bullshit and just understand that, like I've said a million times over, we all want the same things, man. We want peace, we want security, we want love, You know, we want compassion for humanity. We want freedom. We want to breathe clean air, not drink polluted water. But yet we're going to fight amongst each other while these people are corrupting all these things that we want. There's no more liberty. There's no more freedom. America's like a firecracker, that the fuse has been lit. It's about to explode any minute. And some people are going to be on the right side. Some people are going to be on the wrong side. And I'm going to be sitting on top of the hill watching it all with my popcorn. So any of y'all, welcome to join me on top of the hill. And we can watch this shit go down in flames. Or we can all try to do something about it. I don't know. That's my rant for the day.